Sham, how can I find out if my candidates, the people applying for my job, are good or not? Do you have any tips for me? And this is what we're going to be answering in this question in 3, 2, 1, and here we go. Hello, everybody. My name is Sham, known in the community as the responsible restaurant owner. And sometimes people ask me, Sham, how can I make sure that the people coming to apply for my restaurant are as good as their resume says they are? And these are three things you can do to quickly determine where they fit inside your organization. So one, I always ask them to describe to me what is your favorite dish. And if they just mention the ingredients and they forget to mention adjectives, mainly I know that they may not be ready to be lead waiter as of yet. However, once again, do not judge the people that are coming to work for you. There is always room for growth, and you just these questions, these little tricks are a way for you to find out where they stand in your team. Are they going to be entry-level employees? That's somebody that you can trust with more responsibilities. This question should let you know how comfortable they are talking about food. Thing number two that I like to do, I like to give them a computer typing test. Yes, it's a website called 10 Fast Fingers, and it will allow me to find out how fast they can type on the computer. I always ask them, hey, are you comfortable with the computer? Yes. How fast can you type? Oh my gosh, I can type 80 words a minute. Oh really? They're great. I'm not kidding. Let's try it. And you bring the computer and you put them in front of the fact. That will help you find out this may be a candidate that can be amazingly good at working with the computer. Maybe your marketing approach, maybe data entry, whatever they think may be. If you, like me, are a small to medium restaurant size owner, there is sometimes dead times and you do not want to have employees that are doing nothing. So knowing their computer knowledge skill level will allow you to put them to good use when the time is going to be needed. And number three, if I remember it well, the table numbers trick. Yes. So when they will come in, I will tell them, okay, this is table 10, 11, 12, 13. Give them really quick a turnaround of what the table numbers are. And then I will quiz them. So what is this table number? What is this table number? This will show you their ability to actually memorize. Do not be mean when you interview them. You know, the people coming and trying to apply to work for your restaurant is a blessing. My philosophy has always been to always know where they are. Ask them about where they want to be. You know, there is a video that I made called Social Progress. This is a big key to actually employee retention and to lock in those good hires and those good candidates. Know what their plan is. You know, if they just want to come in and work for a month or two during the summer in order to make some extra money, they may not need to go through learning the entire menu up and down. So knowing where they stand, what the goals of your employees are, is a great way to save you lots of money, hustle. So these three little tips, I hope, are going to help you detect who is serious and who is not. And one last tidbit, nugget of information, I always like to give them a script to learn. If they come across as people that pretend that they're going to be serious, that they're going to be there for the long run, well, guess what? I like to give them a script to learn by heart. The script is literally everything you need to say to my guests from the time you come to the doors all the way to when they actually leave the restaurant. This tells me how serious they are. Now, don't get me wrong. If you need employees right there and then, I mean, it's a crisis. You are literally understaffed. Bring people in. But hopefully soon you're going to be in a position where you're going to be able to screen, improve, and be a little bit pickier about the employees that you're going to be hiring. And if that is the case, you can definitely use the script as, hey, looking for the next star. We all, as restaurant owners, are looking for the next star, the next employee who's going to be able to step up to managerial responsibilities, the employee who's going to be responsible, who's going to have a good work ethics or whatnot. It's hard to find, but they are out there. And, you know, as I always like to say, as hospitality professionals, we have done a very bad job at promoting restaurants as an attractive career, and I really think that we need to change that. So I hope this was helpful. Once again, Sham, the responsible restaurant owner. Sorry for the thick accent, but hey, I'm trying to improve on it. Please comment. This video is made for the community. Any feedback, anything I missed, anything wrong that I have done, write it down there, and let's build this. Until we meet again, remember, the secret ingredient is love.